Hello everyone, welcome you all. This is Suresh from Based Automation Channel. Today in this session we're gonna start interacting with ChatGPT with Selenium questions. So we will shoot many questions to ChatGPT and we will see how ChatGPT is helping me to understand with that questions. It's kind of an interview to ChatGPT and I'm trying to ask the questions and I'm getting the answers from the ChatGPT, and you can also learn along with me, and also you can try different questions to ChatGPT, and let's get started. You all know the ChatGPT is an OpenAI, so which will provide you the text-based questions, text-based answers based on the questions that you asked. So let's see. We will ask some basic questions to ChatGPT, and I'm not going to ask very basic, but I'm going to ask some of the questions that maybe you may be encountered during interview also. Let's ask me this question. So I'm asking this question. Selenium locators are 10. Do you agree or not? You can pause the video and tell me in the comment section. Let me ask this question to ChatGPT. Okay. Selenium locators are methods used in the Selenium web driver to locate the element on the web page. Yeah, that's correct. Okay. ID name, class name, tag name. So 4. And link text is a 5, right? Partial link text, says selector, fine, XPath. So it has given me 10. Okay, it is writing me 9th and 10th as well. DOM finds an element based on the document object model structure. Accessibility ID finds an element based on the accessibility ID for a mobile app automation. Have you ever encountered these two types, like DOM and accessibility ID? In case yes, you can comment to me in the comment section. And let me ask one more question related to some exception. So you know, right, what is tail element exception? So don't tell me now, but we will try to understand what ChatGPT says. So this is nothing but state element reference exception is common exception that occurs in Selenium when we're trying to interact with an element that is no longer attached to a page or a DOM. So even you have encountered this type of question, right? So to handle that, see whether you have implemented the same thing in your automation or whether we are getting a new thing from ChatGPT. Okay, these are the various ways that you can mitigate this issue, which is retry, wait mechanism, and you can use the element find again and using a try catch as well. So it is showing me the try catch as well. So overall, the best approach to handle the stale element exception is depends on the specific context and the scenario. That's correct, because we cannot judge or we cannot tell this type of solution will work for that stale element exception. So based on the scenario and based on the context, we have to use it. Fine. So let me ask one more question related to some configuration. So I'm a new to the Selenium automation and I just did some basic level of Selenium coding with using a web driver and all this thing, but I wanted to learn something with respect to the Jenkins. I will ask the same question. So we'll ask this question. I wanted to learn Selenium Jenkins configuration and I wanted to know how to do it. The first and foremost thing is we need to install jar, then we need to install the Selenium plugin. So it is saying how to install that plugin. We need to go to the manage Jenkins. So in case if you are new to this Jenkins, so I have did a sessions on Jenkins. So I will share those sessions in the description. You can find from that. Also, you can refer to ChatGPT also, whichever is helpful for you, you can refer to that. And whatever we did, right, it is giving you the same thing. So configure your Selenium test. Then after that, Selenium create a new Jenkins job, then configure the job. Then after that, we have to configure the Selenium plugin. So all these things we have to do. And here it is giving me in terms of Python, but we did with Java. Fine. So these are all the things that we need to do when it comes to the Selenium Jenkins configuration. So these are information is helpful, and you may be encountering during Selenium Jenkins configuration some issues. So the basic issue is how to trigger particular test from Jenkins. Okay, it starts saying how to trigger. Create a Jenkins job, okay, in the freestyle, then configure the job. So I think the same thing, right? It has said in the previously, okay. I think it is saying differently now. We'll see. Configure the job. So in the job configure, what we are going to do, we are going to build a job with MVN test, okay. And add a post build actions. Yeah, that's true, because we need to add the post build actions to generate a report or send a report. So all these things we need to consider. So the basic test with respect to the Maven Java is using a MVN test. If we have this MVN test in the command line, it will automatically trigger our test, right? So it is saying correct again. Right. Let me ask some more questions with respect to some cloud level, how we can execute. You all know, right? We have a browser stack, we have a device anywhere. Let me ask one question with respect to the browser stack. So I'm asking Selenium and browser stack configuration. Okay, to configure Selenium with browser stack, we need to follow some steps. So creating a browser stack account, yeah, because it is not free, so we have to create an account there. Initially you will get some trial version, so you can learn with that trial version, and then after we need to go with some dependencies if you are using a Maven project. So these are the dependencies, so it is providing your dependencies as well. So it's a one added advantage, because you don't need to go and refer multiple articles regarding this. So you have a dependencies too, and how to write a code also it is giving. So these are the capabilities that we need to set when we are working with the browser stack. So it's a basic simple, so no need to worry on different capabilities that we need to organize. And one way is also like browser stack provides you some predefined set of capabilities you can use accordingly. If you are using a mobile, if you are using a desktop, so all these configurations are already been created in the browser stack. You can refer, and the same thing is typed here too. So you can see this, we have a dependencies, then we have a code that we need to set there into our automation suite. So this is the remote web driver URL that we need to create with capabilities. Again, here also it is giving me correct information. And now I have a different questions related to some configurations like Selenium and CI/CD. So this is also one of the typical question we have seen in many interviews, right? So we'll ask the same question, how to do it, Selenium and CI/CD. Okay, Selenium can be integrated with the continuous integration and continuous development, which is something about CI/CD. And yeah, creating a Selenium test is the first thing we need to do when we are going for CI/CD. It may be anything, test NGJ unit or anything. And we need to set up a version control, that is being whatever the, if you are using a SVN or a gate, we need to store our project there. And then after we need to set up a CI/CD tool. So there are many tools available. It has provided some tools like Jenkins, Strivesy, and GitLab. So these are the some tools, or we can say some environments. And then after we need to configure the build environment. Later on, we need to configure the pipelines. So pipeline in the sense the stages, the goals of each stage we need to set up in there, and we need to integrate our test with CI/CD and set up some notifications. Yes, it is giving me the correct information, but it all text based, right? So you can ask more question related to the CI/CD and how to do exactly, so you can learn with this tool as well. So we'll see some more questions, right? So we have did all configuration related. So we will come to some reports related. So I don't want to go in a basic level because we have to ask very typical questions to this ChatGPT. So I will ask that you all know how to capture a screenshot and put it in your report. But you, have you ever did attaching a video to your report? So we'll ask this question to this. So this is a typical question that you have never did or never tried. So I'm asking these questions to this ChatGPT and we'll see how it will provide me a solution. Okay, to capture an execution, so we need to follow some rule. So adding some libraries or into, I mean, there is some library called Java CV. So even you can use that, and you can use this multimedia library dependency. So you can use both the, and it is giving you the dependency and also the code what you have to use when you are trying to use this in your test execution. So one is the dependency you need to add into your Maven, and you need to create a screenshot record reference. So without having a reference, you cannot start recording, right? So it is giving you the screenshot start recording, and this is the syntax how you should follow. You can copy and paste in your test, and once the screen is started, it will call the start method. To stop, it will call the stop method. And we have to use this both the conditions, because when to start and when to stop. And we need to attach this in our extend report. So as like we are attaching a screenshot, so similar to that, you can attach a video. So which is like this, you can see here. So we have to use this test.log. So log generally we use to for some information capturing into our extend report. And with that information, it is trying to attach this screen capture video using a media entity builder. And after that, it is creating a screenshot capture path, and it is extracting that path and it is capturing into our extent report. So this is a way you can give a try and see. And if you have any issues, let me know. We'll create a session with along with you. Right. So we have did on configuration level, report level, and there are one question, it might be you might be encountering this type of question during the extent report transfer from one person to another person. There will be a missing of images and showing as a broken image. So how can we create a setup so that other person can view those screenshots? So we'll ask this question to ChatGPT. Right, yes, the file path we need to check that, yes, because it is pulling the images based on the file path and file format. Okay, this is also one thing we have to consider. Fine. Okay, image size, we might be seeing the image size, not every time. Okay, network issues. Okay, this is fine. Maybe my question framing is wrong, I guess. Maybe it is understood differently. So on sharing to other person. Okay, on sharing the extend report to the other person, images are getting broken or images are not displaying. How to handle that case? So we'll see. I think it is saying the same thing again. So we are not finding a solution for this, or maybe our question framing is different. It is not understanding. It is understanding in only one way. So I see. Okay. Because the questions we will ask to this ChatGPT, right? So those questions also need to be correctly framed, or else it will not understand, and it will provide you whatever question or whatever the part of the question it understand, it will provide that information. So this is one of the drawback here. So it will not understand every question, right? So there are some potential solutions to address this issue. So one, it is saying that host image online and use a different format, resize images. Okay, we all did the same thing and it is providing the same information again and again. Okay, fine. So these are the various questions that I have asked to the ChatGPT, and you can work on more questions too, or you can frame more questions and ask the ChatGPT, and you can learn more with ChatGPT in terms of automation. So it will not replace you because it will not code for you, but it will provide you the syntax, it will provide you the snippets, it will provide you the information, how to handle, how to use it, and how many different ways that you can use. So it will provide that, and you have to put into your framework automation how to do all these things. I hope this session is helpful for you. In case if you are new to my channel, do subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.